Good day, dear students. Today, we are starting yet another short story. And the title is Her Lover. So, naturally, you are all curious to know about Her Lover. And we are not disappointed in Maxim Gorky, who wrote this short story. And he writes with a lot of heart. And that you can see in the short story. And you speak about Maxim Gorky, you should know that he is one of the prominent writers of Russia. Russia which gave us Leo Tolstoy and a lot of other very good writers. So you find Gorky also belongs to this group. The famous novel or the most famous novel by Maxim Gorky is The Mother. I have, in my youth, I used to hear about the story, the novel, The Mother, and I thought he had written only novels. But now, as we read more about him, we know for sure that his real name is Alexey Maximovich Peshkov. So that name was shortened to Maxim Gorky. He is the prominent Russian writer, and he wrote short stories. And these short stories depict loneliness and alienation in life and even social relations. So this is the type of stories that he writes for us to read on. And it is done with a lot of sensitivity. So you are welcome to the land of Russia and also the conditions of the people there and how they are regarded by the others. The novel, the short story, Her Lover, is about one such character. And the story was narrated and written by somebody else. And that writer is telling the story to somebody else. So that somebody else is the narrator. So we call them the outer narrator. And the story narrator is who narrates is the one person who narrates it in the first person. So we have inner narrator too. So we call the inner narrator a student, that is a Mr. Student, okay. And Mr. Student is from Moscow, and he came across a lady of questionable repute. He was in Moscow, and remember that he is a student. So it was the practice in those times to go over to the city Moscow from the rural areas, and there you will have to cringe and crave and live in poverty if you are a student. And they did not have good accommodation, so they have to find accommodation where it is cheaper. And when you go for a cheap accommodation, you get it only in the very poor and the poorest streets of Moscow. And your company, even though you are a student and maybe you belong to the university or the college, and those others who stay in the other rooms may not be of the same standard. They may not be literate. And they have their own way of living also. So naturally, the student in Moscow came across a lady of questionable repute. That is a very respectable way of saying that she is a lady of loose morals. Okay, questionable repute. This is the term he uses. And her name was Teresa. And moreover, there is additional information about her that she was a Pole. Her physical appearance was not endearing because she was tall, powerful, hefty build, and you find all types of narration which creates in our mind the image of a tall, hefty lady or a woman. But you can just call her a woman, but she has all the strength of a man. Or she was more manly looking than a womanly looking or lady. So the description the student gives us goes on in this manner. She used to hail him as Mr. Student. So they speak loudly, and even though he is a student and he has got a
respectability. He had to live in that area where these different types of people really do live, because it is cheaper. So that's why a student have to be really poor, live in poverty, if you want to learn something or to acquire knowledge from the university or from the colleges. So one day she approaches him with a strange request. Why strange? Because she just do not know how to write. So she wants to send home a letter, and she tells him that she will dictate the letter. So he agreed, well, that's not a problem. Okay, somebody just do not know how to write, and she is dictating, and you need only take down what she is dictating. So she dictates, and he writes a letter addressed to one Boleslav Kashput. And the letter was a lot exaggeration, means it was a real love letter. And why this exaggeration? Because the student is seeing Teresa, and Teresa is standing next to him. So you find the reality and you find a totally different world in the words of Teresa. Anyhow, she is dictating. And so he will have to write down exactly what she is dictating. And finally, she ends the letter to Boleslav, "Thy sorrowing little dove, Teresa." And there is a question mark here, because that question mark is not by Teresa, it is by the student. Because the student just can't imagine Teresa as the little dove. Little dove? That's a question. Because there is nothing little about her. The student, the narrator, who is the narrator, almost laughed out loud. And he is afraid to laugh in the presence of Teresa because she is that intimidating. And there is no littleness or dove-like about Teresa. Because when you hear the words, thy little dove, Teresa, means you have the feeling that it is a beautiful young girl and tender, whose love is always a tender emotion. So that kind of association you have when you read about this, these words, when you come across these words. And that is just dictating. And the student writes down these words, but the reality is standing next to him. And that reality has no littleness, no doubt, like nothing. And so he can't say that to her. So he gives a proper description of Teresa. You can read it in your text. It is interesting. With more than 5 feet high, with the fists of a stone, she was the exact opposite of a little dove, or little, or even dove. You can't call her little. Maybe if the girl is 3 or 4 feet, then you can say, okay, little one. But this is really too much. So he asks as to who this Boles is. So he is curious about this boyfriend of Teresa, because to the boyfriend she is little thou Teresa. So he asks her who this Boles is. She replies that Boles is her young man. Very readily she gives that answer. And let me tell you that a young man, he is my young man, means naturally it is, you remember think of a young girl and a boy dating, and you ask the girl, who is that? He is my young man. He is my young man in the sense that he is the one I am dating. So it is in that sense that term young man is used. And the girl, actually, you expect them to be extremely young. So the terms girl and young man makes Mrs. Student think again, because there is nothing girlish about Teresa, and he is now thinking of the young man of Teresa's. So it remains an imaginary character to him. Teresa offers to do him, to tell you the truth, she is very considerate, because she can't pay him. She is also as poor as a student, and she offers to do him some service in return for the letter writing. She says she will clean his clothes and mend his clothes and things like that. And the student says, no need for her to do these things, because this is not something that is out of his way. and it is only a letter, one page or something, and it's not taking too much of his time. So he refused that because he did not have that heart to ask her to do the work for him. And as a student, he'll have to clean his clothes and mend his clothes and clean the room and cook and do everything. So that is too much for him. But even then, he is so used to it. It's not a hostel that he is living in, mind you. So you will have to think of the student as a very poor student. Poor in the sense, living in poverty, but maybe he is intelligent and he can really survive. So you find that he said, no need for that. Another day, she asked him to write a letter from Bowles to Teresa. So the first letter was to Bowles. That the student accepted, because you can send a letter to anyone, and Bowles is not there, and maybe he is in Poland, and so naturally it is possible. But the second request really made him think. So this letter is from Bowles to Teresa, and it is dictated by Teresa. So now the student understands the truth. And what is that truth? That there is no Bowles, and the Bowles that Teresa speaks of is there in her imagination. And the student really starts to understand the people around him. He is in a different world from these people, and it is just circumstances that made him live there among these people. And these are just common people, extremely poor people. And even their morals are also lacking, but even then you can't really criticize them. They are just very ordinary people, and they also are human beings. So the student, with his wealth of understanding, that makes him a very good student, let me tell you. So he understands the truth, because now the letter is from Bowles to Teresa, that there is no Bowles. But Teresa's logic confounds him, and the logic she tells him is like this. She explains how she gives this letter to someone to read aloud to her. So what happens when somebody reads a letter that she gives to him? That is, the letter that she had dictated to the student had written down the letter. She will take this letter to somebody else, and that somebody will read it aloud to her. So it is like listening to Bowles, the imaginary character, talking to her, speaking to her, all that she wished to hear, all that he is waiting to hear from a young man, though there is no such young man in her life. There is no possibility of having a young man in her life. And the tender feelings that she had in her to be loved, to be someone, to another someone. And maybe this is the reason why Teresa had created a character called Bowles. And the student was really confounded by the logic of this rough lady. And you will find that it is she has this explanation as to how she gives this letter to someone to read aloud to her. And by listening to that man reading aloud such a letter to her, she feels in a happy world of her own that there is some young man to love her. And her lonely life is lightened by these words that tells her that here is someone in this world to love her. We all need someone to love in this world. And Teresa is no different, however rough her life might be. However rough she may look, she also has got this tender heart. And after this, she may be just going out and quarreling and fist fighting with other people and with all types of violence around her. She is into it. But there is a tender heart in her. And the student was really confounded, not just surprised, but he was really confounded by this kind of a logic in such a person. If it were an educated person, he can understand. But this is a totally uneducated lady, and she is living in the world in a rough and tough manner, and she had to fight for her life. and she is doing it. And there is no tenderness about her, and so there is no tender feelings anyone will have for her. Even the student also just do not feel anything for her because of maybe her character or whatever it is that. But you find that she has got some concern because she is asking him to do something and she doesn't want anything to, in return for free. So this is why she asks him that, tells him that she will do the washing for him or even mending for him. And finally he agreed, okay, you can mend my, do the mending. And she does the mending of his clothes and socks and things like that very readily. So she also feels quite happy because the student is student just writes a letter for her. In return for that, she is paying him in this manner. Because in those days, when people are illiterate, they'll have to pay something or the other for the person who writes something for them. And so this is the manner in which she repaid her debts. And this letter makes her extremely happy. So her lonely life is lightened by these words that tell her that here is someone in this world to love her. So here you find that the student is understanding a lot of the attitude of the human beings around him. Till then he regarded them as only poor people having to do hectic work and still there is poverty for them. And their violence and their way of life, everything is not sophisticated, of course. But he is in a totally different world. Even though he is living there, he is in a totally different world. So once this Mr. Student understood her need to be someone for someone, he gets into the act willingly. So with a great imagination, more than the words that Teresa dictates, he writes Bolt's letter. And with great love, Teresa's letter. And here you find that it is done by one person. So he puts all his imagination into it. And with a lot of tender heart, he writes Bolt's letter to Teresa. And Teresa's letter to Bolt also. Teresa will dictate, of course, but he will make the final corrections and things, add a little bit more. And this really made her day. She was so happy. Her letter had a lot of love in it. And Bolt's letter to her has a lot more love for her. And that was enough for her. And in return, she used to mend his socks, shirts and other clothes. And all these were done. And the narrator continues the story. Because his time there is almost over. Because 3 months later, she was put in prison. Because that was the type of life that she usually led. Which will end up in the prison. It's no matter. But even that, that time that she had, she used to dictate and Mr. Student used to write those letters, beautify them and write Bolt's letters for her. And she will take it to somebody else and that somebody will read it aloud for her. Because people who can read will stop for other people to read out things for letters for the others. Because very few of them were literate. And it was, we are speaking of that condition. We are not speaking about the present situation. We are speaking about years back when people were totally illiterate and the privileged or the very rare people who were given education or who were lucky enough to have education were kind enough to read out these letters for the others. That was the practice in those days. So Gorky is hinting at those times also. So there was a time like that, even though you find great literature was produced during that time by Leo Tolstoy, Maxim Gorky, and a lot of others. You find that it is a time when people who were literate were very few. Even among the very rich also, the literariness was very little. And those who could read and write were very few. And you can imagine that the extremely poor people will not be able to do that. So these were the times, and you will find that it is something that you will have to remember in life also. So Maxim Gorky and Russia had seen the change of the regime and the communist regime coming over, but even then he quarreled with them and so it was not for him to remain with them, because you find that the restrictions imposed on him on his writing were not something that he could accept. So these people who could read and write also really suffered. So you are getting to know about another class of people, not just the literate people, but also about the fallen classes. He calls them the fallen classes, and Teresa belongs to that class. And this is why you find that her tender emotions were presented in such a manner. This is surprising because she shares it with only Mr. Student. And the title that, or the name that she gives him, is really a great honor, because being Mr. Student, not Mr. Principal or Mr. Lecturer or Mr. Teacher, but Mr. Student, shows that how valuable the work of a student is. So she addresses him respectfully as Mr. Student, and she comes down, or she becomes almost a totally different person before him. No quarrel with him, no using violence, nothing. She needs only certain things from him, and this is it. That is in the form of letters. So here the narrator concludes the story, wondering about humanism and about the fallen classes. The fallen classes, what do you mean by that? Because the fallen classes means the people who belong to a certain category, who are not acceptable to the society, a lady of loose morals. You never, whatever, however progressive the society might be, you won't look at them with a lot of love or respect. Naturally, they will be pushed to one side. So we call them the fallen classes. So there are a lot of people like that. But now he is wondering whether there is any humanism in them, or whether you can show any humanism to these people. And Mr. Student feels quite happy that he was able to be of help to her in a totally different capacity. And it is that he narrates in this very short story. So Maxim Gorky can write short stories, and he writes it with a lot of feelings, and you get to know about that particular world that he lived in, and that class division, and everything is there. So the story tells you about certain preconceived notions about people, especially about the fallen classes, and how wrong we are about them. And it is that Mr. Student is revealing to the narrator. As I told you in the beginning, there is an outer narrator and there is an inner narrator. The inner narrator is is Mr. Student, and the outer narrator is the storyteller, that is the author himself, maybe. So this is the first person writing, and you'll find a lot of conversation, but at the same time, you find the description of Teresa, the way she moves on, her physical description, because that is really important. You look upon a hefty person as a really strong person, but it is not so. That strong person also has got tender emotions, and it is that which is focused here. And he is now wondering about humanism and also about fallen classes. So when you speak about these fallen classes, and naturally you will have to think again whether they are really fallen, or whether we should alienate them from society, and all these are put as question marks for us. He is not taking sides. The author, Maxim Gorky, is not taking sides, but he is putting before us a situation a student has encountered, and that student is in a way a totally different concept from the way we give the term now, use the term now. You are a student, those who are listening, and is this how you behave? Or we have a lot of facilities, lots of facilities, not just cringing and craving and having only one meal a day and going without fire during the extreme cold winters of Russia. This is how a student survived in those times. And you are getting into the life of a student of that times. So Maxim Gorky is presenting before us the life in Russia and also of elsewhere at that particular time. And and it is interesting to note how they survived and the life lessons they learned from the people around them. And this is one in such instance. And dear students, read through the story in full, get proper explanations. The explanations are there, but even then you will have to go through the questions which are there, and also read and enjoy these short stories, understand them, and you know, this will inspire to read more works of Maxim Gorky, and the same goes for other short story writers. I hope I have really instilled an interest in short stories in your mind, so that you can take up any collection from any short story writer you like and read them and enjoy them. Okay, it won't take much time. It takes very little time to read a short story and enjoy that. Okay, thank you. Meet again in the next class.